Dr. Pandey, for giving me chance to speak in this session on pediatric cataract surgery in the Chinese. Implantation of the IUL, posterior capsulotomy was initiated because it is must to do posterior capsulotomy in such patient, otherwise because this is in the visual axis total plaque, we completed it. And I think you must have seen this is a small video, not full video, child with the double crystalline lens, where we planned two continuous curvilinear capsular axis in each of the crystalline lenses, and then remove the cortical material from the capsular bag, and then we planned a customized IUL. This is a customized IUL, big IUL, I think 19 millimeter overall diameter. And it was implanted into capsular bag, as you can see. And this is amblyopia therapy given, and child could see, and he was very confident to catch these object, and smallest he kept with him, no? Otherwise, other he has thrown. And then high corneal astigmatism. Here we used Callisto. In children, if marking is possible, because marking has to be done before, then almost 5 millimeter continuous curvilinear capsular axis, and hydrodissection and removal of the cortex. It is not possible to remove total lens epithelial cells. And it is a toric IUL. So here we are implanting hydrophobic acrylic IUL into capsular bag, and aligned it in this final destination along the Callisto, as it you can see it, and even you can apply suture to the main incision. Then come this juvenile idiopathic arthritis and cataract, total posterior synecdoche. So ideally, we should put a Malleusin ring or Bhattacharjee ring. You can put that time. This was done about, I think, more than six years back. So that time only these Malleusin ring were available, and this is application of the Malleusian ring followed by staining and continuous curvilinear capsular axis, and then implantation of even you can put single piece IOL, because we don't have so much stock of these IOL, so whatever we ask from the patient we use. Even small peripheral iodectomy was done in this case. And then this is a child with lenticular coloboma, gross. Here we wanted to ensure that we make scleral flap. Synecdoche was done. Viscoelastic, continuous curvilinear capsular axis. And then application of the capsular hook to the rexis margin. These are the blunt edge of these capsular rexis hooks compared to the iris hooks, which are sharp. But many times we have used that also for rexis. Here this is a single islet Sioni ring. This was implanted for stabilization of the capsular bag. And here we are implanting toric IOL. And this is the final picture. It looks excellent at the end. And this is just before and after, you can see here, and on the other side, just excellent pictures. And then come congenital glaucoma child, referred to us with the visually significant cataract. You can see this long tube. And because pupil was small, we have used Malleusian ring to dilate it further. Cataract was in the visual axis. Removal of the cortex and then implantation of IOL and removal of this Malleusian ring, and this tube was trimmed because it was too long. This is 3-year-old child with unilateral myopia of anisometropia was there, 17 minus 17 glasses he was using, very high myope. That time there was no much other option than because it was a unilateral very high myopia. You can see the half striae here, here and here, typical of Bouffthalmos. Here IOL was captured because it was put into sulcus and captured into capsular bag. Because these IOLs otherwise they will rotate around, and because fixation to capsular axis is important. Child got good vision. Amblyopia therapy was initiated. This is another patient with PHPV. This was done more than 10 years back, so that time it was a complex situation. Vascularized membrane was there. It, it is very difficult to cut this posterior capsule, so you have to make a nick in the posterior capsule and do capsulotomy. If there is any stalk, you have to do cauterization. Here also there is a bleed in this case because cauterization was not done initially and no IUL was implanted in this child. It was left affected. This is another child, 4 month old child with PHPV. It was diagnosed before because as you can see now vascularized membrane is there and you can see the stalk also, there is a stalk, and then cauterization of the posterior capsule. A small nick was made in the posterior capsule. And then capsulotomy was done using vena scissor and stalk was cauterized to prevent the bleed. And then you can see the final picture, and then IUL was implanted in this case in the capsular bag. So you have to enlarge the rexis, and these are the various different pictures of the same case. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Dr. Jagatram sir, for sharing very difficult cases of children. I would like to ask you what are your recommendation for putting IUL in less than 2 years of age?
I think there is no problem. Yesterday there was debate, mm-hmm. and up to 6 months no issue, because a FACIA treatment study group has said that up to 6 months or more, mm-hmm. complication rate remains same. If it is less than 6 months, complication rate particularly higher chances of PCO, higher chances of secondary glaucoma, mm-hmm. that are much higher in less than 6 months.
Okay,
so we are using up to 6 months. There is no issue. Even less than 6 months we are, but you have to be much more careful if you do in less than 6 months.
Okay, sir.
You should not do if there is a microcornea, microophthalmos, or if it is a something PHPV in a microcornea, microophthalmos. Or okay. Axial length is less than 16.5 millimeter.
Okay, sir. And what is your recommendation to do cataract surgery for unilateral cataract if there is a visually significant cataract?
Ideally, if it is a unilateral cataract where there is visually significant cataract, there you have to by and large we implant IOL.
Okay.
Because otherwise in our situation contact lens may not work most of the time. Poor patients, mm-hmm. many of them are poor.
Yes.
Until unless it is contraindicated. If not contraindicated, IOL is the best, and outcome is poor due to amblyopia. So you have to initiate amblyopia therapy. Almost 40-45% of these children unilateral cataract, they get 20/40 or better visual acuity in any of the study.
Okay. And how do you adjust the lens power in less than 2 years of age?
There are so many things. We use even SRKT formula. Initially we use SRK2 formula, but now there are also Dahan's guidelines. These came in 1997. Accordingly, less than 2 year use almost 20% reduction. More than two to eight year you use 10% IOL power reduction.
Okay.
To compensate for myopia.
Okay.
But you don't keep so much hypermetropia in the postoperative period. That child remains there may be much more isometropia, so you have to adjust that. Okay. But these are the broad guidelines, what formula or guidelines you should use.
Okay, sir. So any question for Dr. Jagadram, sir? Okay, please. You can come.
Cataract in juvenile rheumatoid arthritis. Some recommend not to implant IOL because of severe reaction post-implantation.
I understand your question that in a JIA, juvenile idiopathic arthritis or juvenile rheumatoid arthritis, whether to implant IOL or not. In the past, about I think 30 years back, we were not even implanting IOL in these cases. But now, we have a much better experience, and if such as one of the child was JIA where there were 360 degree posterior synecdoche, if IOL is implanted in the capsular bag, chances of complication are less. If they are implanted in the sulcus, chances of complication are more. So you have to be very, very careful in these children with JIA while implanting IOL, because chances of secondary glaucoma and recurrence are much higher compared to other.
Do you inject intraocular steroid post-op? Intraocular.
Yes. Steroid, we use subconjunctival steroid in these cases, but we also give, sometime we have now initiated giving Azurdex, that is the Dex implant, that is just 700 microgram into vitreous cavity in recurrent uveitis, and some of these patients with the JIA or juvenile idiopathic arthritis. So that help to prevent inflammation and complication in the postoperative period.
So which IOL, sir, do you recommend for these cases? Like previously, Pharmacia was manufacturing heparin surface modified lenses. Which hydrophobic is better or hydrophilic? You prefer for hydrophilic?
No, hydrophilic should not be used.
Okay.
Hydrophobic IOL or you use heparin surface modified IOL. In the past, we used to use Pharmacia IOL long back, about I think 30 years back.
I think
I am not sure about it. Maybe Dr. Pandey is sure, but we are using hydrophobic acrylic IOL. But that time, I have several of the pictures where Pharmacia was heparin surface modified Pharmacia IOL. That was PMM IOL. That time it was used, but I am not sure about that at present which heparin surface modified IOL is
available. I don't
think
it's available. Yes. Ozone surface modified.
Okay. Yeah, that is the alternative probably.
Yes. And sir, do you think that downsizing of the IOL is important in infants or like in microphthalmos? You have mentioned that you should not use the IOL, but in less than 1 year of age.
I think that is a good idea. And M.E. Wilson, who has done a lot of work in pediatric cataract surgery, he also recommend. And I think Vasavada also recommend downsizing of IOL, particularly M.E. Wilson. So actually, making customized IOL company usually don't make it. It is not very cost effective, but otherwise it is ideal to downsize the IOL for particularly these children with microphthalmos, wherever you can implant.
Okay.
So downsizing is a good idea, but we are not doing it.
Okay. So thank you.